ChatGPT. You probably have used it to help you with important tasks, or even reaffirm your controversial takes on things like how you should eat breakfast. Yet, you can trick ChatGPT to believe that 2 plus 2 equals to 5, or gaslight it until it apologizes for doing simple arithmetic correctly. Weird, isn't it? How can it be so smart, while getting stumped or tricked by something so simple? In this video, I will show you how large language models like ChatGPT work and why it is no different from how we use language in our day-to-day lives, while tying it all back to our original question. Before we jump into generating full sentences, let's start with something simple. Imagine we want to create a program that writes a song in the style of Rick Astley, an artist I'm sure most of you are familiar with. Assume our program does not have any reference on how his song should sound like. Now, a very straightforward solution would be to generate all possible combinations of words until we find one which sounds like Rick Astley. Possible, but really inefficient. According to the Oxford English Dictionary, there are approximately 600,000 words that currently exist. This means we will need to sieve through 600,000 to the power of 10 combinations just to find a good fit for 10 words. What if instead, we have a heuristic to make a good guess of what the next phrase will be? Or by scoping down the problem, what the next word will be? This is where we go one step further in improving our method and using existing lyrics to help us. Let's look at the iconic song, Never Gonna Give You Up. Instead of generating lyrics at random, we count the number of times a particular word occurs in the song. Turns out in natural languages like English, the frequency in which a word is used is a good indicator of what will sensibly occur in the sentence. To accurately deduce the frequencies, we can collate as much text and data of his songs and analyze them. In linguistics, we call this collection a corpus. We can thus represent occurrences as probabilities, which can be calculated by taking the number of times a word appears, divided by the total number of words in the whole corpus. To create a sentence, for example, we randomly generate a word at each point using these probabilities. This is a better strategy, but we can see that our output does not sound right. This is because every word is created independently, without regard for the previous one. In a sense, our method does not consider any knowledge of the past. This is known as a disregard for existing context. If we were to look back at the case where we told ChatGPT that it was wrong, our method most likely won't even know to apologize because it doesn't remember anything about the context of the conversation. If we used a generalized English corpus, for example, it will simply generate words that we frequently use in our day-to-day lives using our probability method, which creates random sentences like this. Somewhat English, but nowhere close to coherent like ChatGPT. Well, we can fix that by creating context, allowing us to remember the previous word. Here is a short segment from the Rick Rose song we have used. Instead of thinking of this as just words, we can visualize it in the form of a timeline. Each word in the sentence flows across time, and we can illustrate this by connecting them with arrows. These arrows represent what is known as a happens-before relationship, where A is the word that occurs before B. Back to our example, we see that the word gonna appears 3 times, and is always after never. So let's simplify and merge these transitions, rearranging our list-like structure into a graph. We do a similar simplification for the word you. Oh, let's not forget to add the arrows back to never to represent the flow between sentences as well. This looks nice, but we have a problem. The graph consists of endless cycles that we can't break out of. To fix this, I'll add an epsilon symbol here, which is a convention to denote the end of the sequence. Cool, now our graph is complete. We see that for this word here, there are 3 unique paths we can take. Gonna give, gonna let, and gonna turn. Each of these paths can be taken with a certain probability. We can borrow the idea of the counting method previously to perform the calculations. Here, we deal with the counts of the transitions instead of just the number of words itself. Since each word give, let, turn occurs only once, we we find that there's an equal 1/3 chance of us taking each path. Note the difference between this and our original counting method, which simply considers the frequency of a word occurring. In our case, context exists because we take into account the history before our current word. At this point, you may realize that what we are doing is actually calculating the conditional probability. Each path represents the probability of give, let, or turn conditional upon the previous word, gonna. Similarly, we see that U leads to either up, down, or epsilon, and we note the likelihood of taking each path, which is 1/3 each as well. And just by assigning probabilities to the arrows, we have created a language model. We can then complete the language model by doing the same procedure across all Rick Astley songs. If we keep doing this and expand the model by taking the data from the internet, such as Reddit, we would then have created a large language model. Now we see our conversations with ChatGPT are part of a graph. Since we tend to apologize when people tell us that we did something wrong, that is also reflected in the language model. Hence, ChatGPT sees that based on the context of the sentence and also apologizes. It is choosing the most likely outcome based on existing context, which is the use of conditional probability. We observe that ChatGPT hence does not always know what is factually correct. It simply creates sentences that sounds right. By now, you might have realized that I made the models look back at only one word for context. But as you know, that makes the AI very short-sighted. Going back to our Rick Astley language model, we see that I can reconstruct the original lyrics as intended. At times, it also creates something amusing. But it seems to produce tons of gibberish as well. This is because our model only has knowledge of the word prior to it, as expressed by this conditional probability. To improve its memory, we need to condition the word to be generated based on more words in the past, expanding the conditionals. For a table of a two-word context, we call it a bigram. For three words, a trigram. And for n words, n-grams. However, this is where it gets very tricky to compute, and neural networks come in handy to help approximate the probabilities. On top of that, ChatGPT also uses the attention mechanism to expand its memory and remember what it has seen before. But that's probably a whole topic for another time in a part 2 video. If you enjoyed my first video, do leave a like and please subscribe to see more interesting computer science content. It really means a lot to me as a small creator and helps me understand what you enjoy. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.